Hello, hello, Wojciech Lepczyński here. Today's video will be about warming up the lambda function and cold starts. I show you how lambda function work under the hood. This video contains several sections, so you can move freely between them. We will talk first about lambda execution environment lifecycle. Then I will talk more about cold starts. Finally, I will show a demo in which I added a trigger and a short piece of code that allows you to quickly warm up the lambda function. I hope it will give you a better understanding of how lambda function warmup works. However, you must be aware that this is just a small part of what the lambda function does behind the scene. Okay, let's start. Lambda invokes your function in execution environment, which provides a secure and isolated runtime environment. The execution environment manages the resources required to run your function. The execution environment also provides lifecycle support for the function's runtime and any external extension associated with your function. When you create your Lambda function, you specify configuration information, such as the amount of memory available and the maximum execution time allowed for your function. Lambda uses this information to set up the execution environment. Each phase starts with an event that Lambda sends to the runtime and to all registered extensions. The runtime and each extension indicate completion by sending a next API request. The Lambda freezes the execution environment when the runtime and each extension have completed and there are no pending events. As you can see, we have several phases of launching the Lambda function: init, invoke, and shutdown. In the init phase, Lambda performs three tasks. Extension init starts all extensions. Runtime init bootstraps the runtime. And function init runs the function's static code. The init phase ends when the runtime and all extension signals that they are ready by sending a next API request. The invoke phase. When a Lambda function is invoked in response to a next API request, Lambda sends an invoke event to the runtime and to each extension. The shutdown phase. When Lambda is about to shut down the runtime, it sends a shutdown event to each registered external extension. Extensions can use this time for final cleanup task. The shutdown event is a response to a next API request. The entire shutdown phase is capped at 2 seconds. If the runtime or any extension doesn't respond, Lambda terminates it via signal sickkill. Not every Lambda function run is the same. For example, after the function and all extensions have completed, Lambda maintains the execution environment for some time in anticipation of another function invocation. In effect, Lambda freezes the execution environment. When the function is invoked again, Lambda tows the environment for reuse. To dive deeper and see more, I turned on tracking. Thanks to this, in X-ray, you can see more. In the first run of the Lambda function, you can see the initialization phase, but in the second run, it's no longer there. This is because the environment already exists and has been reused. Thanks to this, we speed up the execution of our function. Prevent cold start. When Lambda snap start is activated, the init phase happens when you publish a function version. Lambda saves a snapshot of the memory and disk state of the initialized execution environment, persists the encrypted snapshot, and caches it for low latency access. If you have a before checkpoint runtime hook, then the code runs at the end of init phase. You can also use provision concurrency. Lambda initializes the execution environment when you configure setting of a function. Lambda also ensures that initialized execution environments are always available in advance of invocations. You may see gap between your function's invocation and initialization phases. Depending on your function's runtime and memory configuration, you may also see variable latency on the first invocation or an initialized execution environment. Small the advantages of this solution is price. Because you always have a ready environment available, this means you have to pay for it. I don't remember how much, but it was quite a large amount of money. If you are curious, you can find the current price, for example, in AWS calculator. Okay, to prevent cold start, you can simply run the Lambda function before the environment is destroyed. The important thing is that you don't have to run the entire code of your Lambda function to warm up. Okay, but how can you automatically warm up the environment for the Lambda function? For the test, I prepared a Lambda function and a simple trigger. If you are curious what it looks like in practice, please watch the next part of the video, in which I will soon show you a simple way to warm up the Lambda function. It will give you a better understanding of what warming up the Lambda function is all about. I encourage you to conduct your own experiments. This way people learn faster by conducting tests themselves. Okay, let's go to AWS console. Create function. Let's add some name. For example, lambda cold start, runtime python 3.11, and use an existing role. I choose AWS lambda basic execution role. Create function. Let's add some code. I don't need this. Only warming equals event get cold start. If only warming equals warming, return some text, for example, warming up the Lambda function. Else, return your code. Let's print also this warming. Deploy and test. Event name, for example, test. And save. So let's test. This is not warming, and as you can see, the response is add your code. Let's create new test. For example, only warming. And let's add cold start equals warming. And let's test this. Only warming, test. As you can see, now the response is warming up the Lambda function. Let's change the configuration. We can add some trigger. For example, CloudWatch event. Create new role. Role name, for example, Lambda Warmup 01. Let's add some schedule expression. Rate 5 minutes. Thanks to this, we will automatically run this function every 5 minutes. Okay, let's add, but that's not the end. Let's edit this trigger. Select targets, additional settings, constant JSON text, and we can copy value from our test. Cold start equals warming. Thanks to this, we will only warm up the function every 5 minutes. We won't run the whole code. We run just a small piece for warm up. Update. I can also copy the code from my previous Lambda, the one I made in another video, because I have it in this region. But you can add whatever you want. Okay, I don't need this. Let's add some space here. One more time. I don't need this now. Okay. Let's test. Yep. Everything works. So, thanks to the trigger, my function will be warmed up every 5 minutes and I can run it whenever I want in a heated environment. As you can see, the Lambda function has been heated up several times. When I go into details, you can see that the initialization phase is missing. There is no initialization phase because the environment still exists. Now, when I run my function manually, there should be no initialization phase either. As you can see, the environment still exists, my code is loaded. Of course, everything has its price. I don't waste time on initialization because I warm up my function every 5 minutes and I pay for it. Thanks for watching. This is the end for today. Another video coming soon. Subscribe and don't miss it. Oh, of course, check my blog on Lepczynski IT. You will find there a lot of tutorials that will show you how to use the AWS cloud and take you step by step to the next level. Thanks for watching.